I'd like to call to order this meeting of the Oldham County Board of Education. It's February 27th, 2012, and we are at North Oldham High School. The first item of business is to approve the agenda. Corrections or additions, Superintendent?
We do have some additions under consent items, under B, number two. We've added to consider approval of a change order in BG4 for North Oldham High School. Item 11, consider approval of a waiver request for Brownsboro Elementary School. And 12, consider approval of award for a contract for waterline at the bus company.
All right, thank you, sir. And board members, you have those supplemental enclosures. So hearing those additions, may I have a motion to approve the agenda, please? Motion was made by Mr. Dodson, seconded by Mr. Woosley. All those in favor? That's 5-0. Thank you, sir. We need to immediately recess the Oldham County Board of Education and call to order the Oldham County School District Finance Corporation. And I believe Ms. Corson is here to present some material to us. The first order of business, however, will be to approve a set of minutes from the last Oldham County District Finance Corporation. First of all, let's approve the agenda, please. May I have a motion to approve the agenda for Finance Corporation business?
So moved, Madam Chair.
Motion made by Mr. Shuman, seconded by Ms. Beckner. All those in favor, and that's 5-0. We now need to approve the minutes from the November 28th, 2011 Finance Corporation meeting. May I have a motion to approve those minutes? Motion made by Mr. Woosley, seconded by Mr. Dodson. All those in favor, and that's 5-0. Thank you all. Ms. Corson, would you like to lead us through this action item?
Yes, we discovered, I don't think this is on.
Yes, it is.
Oh, we discovered when we had the water break at North Oldham Middle School that the Little Water Company didn't actually have an easement for the fire service when it was installed many years ago. They are now asking for an easement and to allow them to, you know, maintain the line if there's any issues with it. But we did get that sorted out. And the reason, I guess, they shut off all the water over there is because they didn't show an easement on the plat, so they didn't know that the service ran from where the old water tower was over to North Oldham Middle School, and that's the fire service, so we want to keep that in place. And they've fixed all the various pipes and conduits, so it's up and running, and we just need to give them an easement. The reason you all are approving it in the Finance Corporation is because technically the Finance Corporation owns that property. It was transferred when we took out some bonds to do construction. So
yes,
we are asking you to approve it in the District Finance Corporation, and we'll probably be asking you to approve it in the board as well.
Nice summary, Ms. Corson. Thank you. Questions, board members? May I have a motion to approve this action item then, please?
So moved.
Motion made by Mr. Shum, seconded by Mr. Woosley. All those in favor, and that's 5-0. Thank you, Ms. Corson. At this time, I need a motion to adjourn the Oldham County District Finance Corporation, please. Motion made by Mr. Dodson, seconded by Ms. Beckner. All those in favor, and that's 5-0. Thank you all. We will reconvene the Oldham County Board of Education at this time. And I think we are ready at this time, Mr. Davis, to go right ahead with the treasurer's report, sir. Welcome.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Appreciate y'all letting me have this opportunity. If you would, I assume you've had a chance to review. And if you would mind turning to the treasurer's report there, I'll go through this. On the first page, basically, is a summary of the various accounts, and you can see the total balance in the cash. Everything has been reconciled. Items are all in balance. If you wouldn't mind turning to the next page there, please stop me if you have any questions. You can see there that basically there's no securities or anything subject in where you have the investments line. Basically, everything's in cash, money market accounts. You can see down there the balances, and again, these are as of January 31. the page four there, the treasurer's report for the food service, you can see the balance there is $1,000,003. And on the next page, on page five, is basically the some construction funds. Basically, you can see the jobs that where there's still funds sitting out there, and those are the balances to be paid, and those will be paid out as we go along. Those are estimates. There could be some changes, but we tried to estimate based on the outstanding amounts that still are out that will be paid in the future. Over on page six, this is just a summary to give you an idea of where we stand in terms of the general cash, general fund cash balance. You can see there we got $24.7 million as compared to $25.7 million last year. You can see the percentage of our budget. It's running right about the same, right at 23% there. So everything is pretty much in line with what it has been in the previous year. And then on the next page, on page seven, just gives you the bonding capacity as of current date. Of course, that will change once the bonds issued for Brownsboro and Centerfield. But we have $58.4 million bonding capacity as of now. The pages after that, you'll see the beginning on page eight, basically the balance sheet. And this is just a snapshot of where we are as of January 31. Nothing really to highlight on here. You can see the cash balances again under the general fund. The liabilities that you see there are items that have been basically withheld or accrued that would be paid out, that were paid out in February. The biggest items down there you can see is just the retirement withholding and the Kentucky state, the health, and those type items. Again, those are withheld out of payroll and then paid in the subsequent month. Let's see, back on, I guess you'd go back a little bit farther to where the revenues start, back on page, I guess it'd be page 17. Just gives you an idea of where revenues and expenditures for the month of January and also year to date. The majority of the revenues for the month came from property taxes, about $2.1 million. We had utility tax, about $300,000, and we had SEEK, about $3.1 million during the month. That's where the revenues came in. The expenditures basically are salaries, wages, those type items. Overall, nothing really changed much from fairly consistent with the previous year or previous month. So the recommendation here is to approve the treasurer's report as presented.
All right, thank you, Mr. Davis. Nice thorough summary. Questions or comments, board members, on the treasurer's report? Motion to approve treasurer's report, please.
So moved.
Motion made by Mr. Shum and seconded by Mr. Woosley. All those in favor, and that's 5-0. Thank you. Would you walk us through bills and claims,
sure,
please, glad Mr.
To
Davis?
Just turn to the bills and claims. Basically, the first page there is a summary of the number. We have 1,170 items here that are subject to your approval. You see the amounts over there as to whether it's pre-approval or post-approval. We got $5.7 million worth of expenditures looking at approval. If you have any questions on those, there wasn't really anything, you know, particular that I wanted to look at. There's back on, I guess it's, let's see which page it is, on page 10, I believe, there's a payment to Morrell Construction, $156,000. That's a major item for the month. That's just the contractor invoice on the annex and the bus garage. There's various items in there that are the same payment amount that we've looked at those. Those are different invoices, but there's just, they happen to be the same amount. The same items were purchased in terms of maybe two iPads, four iPads, whatever, but those are not duplicate amounts. Overall, I think that's pretty much everything in terms of the bills and claims. Just be open to any questions that you might have. If I can't answer the question, I'll get the answer for you.
Questions or comments, board members? I would just make note that on page 21, there is an item reflecting our payment to Oldham County for our stormwater fee for 2011, which was significant, $25,000.
Right. There's
also a 2010.
There's also a 2010 payment and 2011 payment, both right at $26,000.
Yes. Thank you. Other questions or comments? Motion to approve bills and claims made by Mr. Dodson, seconded by Mr. Shum. All those in favor, and that's 5-0. Thank you, Mr. Davis.
Thank you very much.
Well done. We have several sets of minutes to approve, board members. The first set of minutes that you will see, I believe, is our regularly scheduled school board meeting from January 30th, 2012. Are there any corrections or additions to those minutes? All right, motion to approve, made by Mr. Woosley, seconded by Ms. Beckner. All those in favor, and that's 5-0. Thank you all. We had four special called meetings last month of our school's site-based council meetings, which were very interesting and enjoyable. We will approve those minutes one at a time, and I commend the board members for being able to attend all of those meetings within a two-week period. Let's go to the first set of minutes. I'm trying to find mine. The first set of minutes is for January 31st, 2012. Should have been 31st. Motion to approve, made by Ms. Beckner. Seconded by Mr. Woosley. All those in favor, and that's 5-0. Thank you. The next set of minutes was for February 2nd special called meeting. Corrections. Motion to approve, made by Mr. Dodson, seconded by Mr. Woosley. All those in favor, that's 5-0. The next set of minutes, February 7th, 2012, special called meeting. Any corrections? Motion to approve, made by Mr. Shum, seconded by Mr. Woosley. All those in favor. And that's 5-0. And the last set of minutes for these special call meetings are from February 9th, 2012. Corrections. Motion to approve, made by Mr. Dodson, seconded by Mr. Woosley. All those in favor. And that's 5-0. Thanks, guys.
Thanks, Gil.
Superintendent, we are ready for our personnel actions, please, sir.
Yes. I did want to call attention to one retirement. Ms. Donna Burns has served as executive secretary for the maintenance department for I'm not sure how many years, but I know a long time. Nancy, do you have any idea?
I would say at least 25.
Yeah, many years. I wanted to just thank her for all those years of service. Other than that, I'm just asking to add these to the record. Yes. 30 and a half. Wow, that's significant.
So we celebrate all those years of commitment to Oldham County School District and wish her the best in her retirement.
Yes.
And any other comments or questions on the personnel actions? All right, thank you, Superintendent. We have consent agenda items with the corrections A through D. What's your recommendation, Superintendent?
To approve these, please.
Motion to approve the consent agenda items, please. Made by Ms. Beckner, seconded by Mr. Dodson. All those in favor, and that's 5-0. Thank you, everybody. At this time, we need to go into executive session. And we will discuss the following matters: litigation concerning a student personnel matter, litigation involving Title IX athletics, and potential litigation regarding a district construction project. The board needs to go into executive session pursuant to KRS 61.810C to meet with the board's attorney regarding preparation and strategy, the public disclosure of which would jeopardize the board's position. May I have a motion for us to go into executive session, please? Motion made by Mr. Dodson, seconded by Ms. Beckner. All those in favor, and that's 5-0. Thank you all. Good afternoon. The board has just come back from executive session. Is there any action coming out of executive session, board members?
Yes, Madam Chair. We have a motion.
Yes, sir.
I move that the Louisville Water Company is requesting an easement for the original installation of fire services at North Oldham Middle School, and in order to access the pipe for future maintenance, I move to approve, I think the board approves the easement for North Oldham Middle School in favor of Louisville Water Company. That is the same easement approved by the District Finance Corporation earlier this evening.
Thank you, Mr. Shum. Is there a second to that motion? This motion was made by Mr. Shum and seconded by Mr. Dodson. All those in favor, and that's 5-0. Thank you. Welcome, everybody, to our school board for February school board meeting for February 2012 at North Oldham High School. We want to thank Ms. Lisa Jarrett and her staff for hosting us, and the high school looks fabulous, and we look forward to your student showcase a little bit later. Before we move on with business, I believe the superintendent has an announcement he'd like to make.
This evening with a very special award recognition. Mr. Don Flew is here with us from the Kentucky Association of School Business Officials. And I'm going to ask him to come up. He has a very special celebration and award presentation at this time.
And members of the board, good evening. As the superintendent said, my name is Don Flew, and I am the finance director of Boyd County Public Schools in Eastern Kentucky. I am here tonight with a few of my colleagues. I know for sure in the audience we have Greg Murphy of Shelby County, and Joy Campbell of Danville Independent, and Kathy and Brian Pelletier of Tyler Technologies. We may have some others. I'm not sure if they were able to make it or not. Tonight we are here representing the Kentucky Association of School Business Officials, or CASBO. If you're not familiar with CASBO, its members work in public school district business offices throughout the Commonwealth in areas such as payroll, accounts payable and receivable, budgeting, and financial reporting. Each year, CASBO selects someone who is a shining example of what a school finance person should be to receive special recognition. Someone who not only does a wonderful job with his or her own school district, but who enables other school people to excel as well. I'm honored tonight to tell you that the CASBO Goldenrod Award for the Outstanding School Business Official of 2012 goes to Charles Chuck Little. Before we have Chuck come up and receive his award, I'd like to say a few other things about him. You're probably all aware of the outstanding job that Chuck does for the students and the taxpayers of Oldham County, but you may not be aware of the impact that he's had on school business personnel statewide. Time will not permit me to list all of Chuck's accomplishments, but I do want to highlight a few. Chuck is known and respected throughout the state. On the local level, Chuck has mentored several finance officers from neighboring districts. He always makes time to listen and offer practical advice. Chuck's statewide contributions were confirmed when he became one of the original advisors of the Kentucky Department of Education and the University of Kentucky's Gatton College of Business in their creation of the Gatton School Financial Management Institute. This three-year program provides professional training to school finance folks from every corner of Kentucky. Almost 200 people have completed this training to become certified school financial managers to better serve their home districts. In the letters of support for Chuck's nomination for this award, many wonderful things were said about him. One sentence in particular said so much about Chuck. Quote, Mr. Literal serves not only as a role model in the professional realm, he also is a model for living a life of service to others, end quote. CASBO is proud and happy to present this award to Chuck Literal. Want it.
Thank you.
In addition to the beautiful memento that Chuck is holding, we also have a couple of other things that come along with this, which are equally nice. The first one is scholarship money. We have a total of $2,250 in scholarship money for a Oldham County student or students of your choosing. $1,000 of that is provided by cash money. $1,000 of that is provided by the CASBO organization, $1,000 is provided by American Fidelity Assurance Company, and $250 is provided by the Southern Association of School Business Officials. Also, if you're interested, there's an all-expense-paid trip to the CASBO meeting in Biloxi, Mississippi in April as part of this, where you will be honored as Kentucky's representative for the Golden Rod Award. And finally, of course, you will be recognized and honored at the CASBO spring meeting in May. Okay. So I want to give you certificates for your other honors there. That's a letter for CASBO. And that's your get-out-of-jail-free card. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Thank you again for your time.
Thank you, Don. I'd like to also point out many of Chuck's team is here. They're the backbone behind what he does as well. We appreciate the sound system a lot, really. Wow, Mr. Ewell, I didn't know you could do that. Anyway, Chuck, we're proud of you. You've done it. I think it's me.
I think it is.
Done an amazing job for many years, and also like to recognize Dr. Blake Hazelton, who worked with Chuck for many years, is here. I appreciate you being here.
Mr. Littrell, on behalf of the whole Board of Education, I just want to say there can't be anybody else in the state of Kentucky that deserves this award more than you do.
Amen.
And I would venture to say, in the national competition as well. You have guided this district to make the very best financial choices and decisions for our students and staff that could possibly be made. And we thank you for that.
Thank you. Thank all of you for being here.
Superintendent.
Yep.
Chucky.
Yep.
Shall we move ahead with the agenda? This is one time we didn't let you have the microphone, Mr. Littrell. You might have noticed.
Yep. Good planning.
We'll talk later. Okay. All right, we're going to move ahead with the agenda then. The next item of business will be the superintendent report. Superintendent, report number one, please.
Mr. Ewald will give us an update this time.
Okay, for the tonight's construction report, mostly we've been in the project completion mode. As you can see, we have the BG4 for this project. North Oldham was on the agenda this evening. Also, we had 9 projects that bid over the last month that was approved at the consent agenda item level. And we were very fortunate in getting a lot of good bids, especially our center field bid came within budget. By the tune of under about $172,000. So feel like we've got a good round of contractors that are going to now be getting prepared to start the shop drawing phases and getting everything together so that once summer does get here, we'll be able to hit the ground running. So that's really the majority of what we've been doing in the last month is working on all these bids.
Right, and you've been busy in that regard, certainly. Questions or comments, board members, for Mr. Ewald? All right, thank you, Mr. Ewald.
Thank you.
Superintendent report number two, please.
This enclosure includes 7 different board policies that we're looking at this time. Ms. Corson has been working on those, and if you have any questions, she can certainly answer those at this time.
Good evening. I know you probably have all read over these policies we're proposing to change. Several of them just have to do with title cleanup and who's responsible for which of these areas. The ones that we are changing substantively are the attendance, just to make clear that a college visit day is not treated as an absence under the before a holiday or after a holiday policy, where normally you would give an unexcused absence for those days. College visits are actually co-curricular, so they're not even really absences. Students can get co-curricular credit if they go to a planned activity at that college. So we're just clearing that up. I think there's been some confusion about college visits. We also wanted to change the number of days, personal days, allowed in the transportation department. It's a very big department, and under the current policy, only two employees, whether they were office employees or bus drivers, were allowed to be off at the same time. This would allow two bus drivers and then two office people to be off during the at the same time. The other revision has to do with the cell phone policy that Ms. Fletcher wanted a chance to review the policy. We are suggesting language that clarifies that bus drivers should not be taking away phones themselves. They need to report that to the administrator, and the administrator will request that the student turn over the phone. We just don't think that they need to have that extra responsibility of trying to force students to turn over their phones. So that just clears that up. And we also had some school staffing allocation guidelines put in our policy that was suggested by Leslie Robertson. The state informed her that we need to actually have the allocation formula in our policy, even though you adopt a different allocation that's, I guess, smaller class size than what's required. But it was suggested to Leslie that we need to have that in our policy.
Thank you for the summary, Ms. Corson. Are there questions or comments at this time, board members? I would like to share with you an additional concern of mine, Ms. Corson, with respect to the telecommunication devices code. In the second paragraph, we say that during the instructional day, a student shall not use a personal telecommunication device while on school property or while attending school-sponsored or school-related activities. I have become aware over the last year that we do have schools who have implemented less severe policies, which it has always been my understanding that schools have the authority to implement more severe policies than the district policies, but not less severe policies. There are some schools, or at least one school I know of, that students are allowed to use their cell phones during the lunchtime. So I'm just asking the question, how do we reconcile that with the district policy?
I think we're going to have to modify the district policy if schools are going to be allowed to designate times during the day where cell phones can be used.
Right. So I guess my question then would be for you perhaps to take a look at what our schools are actually doing, and we need to see something that's more compatible with what schools are doing and what the district really intends as a policy.
Right. That would be your direction.
On that same subject, we've been talking about the use of technology in classrooms, which in a broad brush stroke would include personal communication devices, since in some instructional arenas we're encouraging the students to bring notes and iPads and even the smartphones. I think we need to look at additional language that would encompass the use of those devices for sanctioned instructional purposes.
Our policy currently allows students to use them for educational purposes when it's authorized by an individual teacher, so they can use them in the classrooms right now.
Yes.
If the teacher approves of the use. You know, I think what Ms. Fletcher is talking about is, I think, in
social purposes.
Social purposes.
Yeah, this same paragraph has additional language that already says it shall not prohibit students from using them for educational purposes. I think that's pretty clear, but we need to examine our policy as opposed to what our schools are actually implementing, if you don't mind.
Well, they should be implementing the policy unless you all change the policy.
Exactly.
If you want to look at...
Well, I'm going to speak up here. Some of our principals have had some very innovative ideas to try to motivate not only the students, but the teachers inside the schools to use handheld devices. And so that's where some of that has come from. I think we need to adjust our board policy to what's really going on out there that principals are using to encourage technology. So, and it's going very well with the students at this time.
Right. We can make a change and bring it back next month with this other minor change if you want to get it done.
Yes, certainly. I just want things to be properly aligned, I suppose.
Right.
Okay.
I know there was some pilot stuff going on in the last year.
Yes. So. Okay. All right. Thank you, Ms. Corson. If you all have additional questions or concerns, please share them with Ms. Corson before we need to take action on this item. All right. Superintendent report number two, please. Three.
This enclosure concerns the superintendent search committee. Mr. Johnson, I couldn't be here this evening, so I'm going to give this. The search committee has held 5 meetings since its initial meeting on January 26th. Most of the meetings have exceeded a couple of hours. The majority of the meeting time has been devoted to planning screening activities with careful attention given to designing the types of questions to require candidates to gain an understanding of skill and knowledge and learning assessment, school finance planning, community involvement, and the overall ability to provide visionary leadership to the district. The screening committee has completed an initial review of all the candidates whose credentials meet the minimum requirements requested in the job posting. The list of candidates includes candidates from 4 states outside Kentucky, numerous candidates from Kentucky, and 3 candidates from within the Oldham County schools. The second and next level of screening will involve the search committee members to review the candidate responses to questions answered via a video and by written responses. That review process should be complete by March the 8th. The candidates who are selected for the third level of screening will participate in a Skype interview with the search committee the week of March 12th. And the fourth level of screening, which will be candidate personal interviews with the screening committee, and those will take place on March the 19th. And the board should anticipate a final report from the committee on Monday night, March 26th.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Questions or comments, board members? Mr. Woosley.
I'll just say as the board rep on the SSC.
I'll just tell you that we did get a lot of good candidates, and we still are on target, and we will be having this recommendation to you on the 26th.
Thank you, Mr. Woosley, and thank you for representing the board on the superintendent search committee. Other questions or comments? Thank you, Superintendent. All right, sorry for the interruption. At this time, we would like to move forward with our recognition portion of the evening, and I've asked Mr. Dodson to assist the superintendent with that.
Oldham County Middle School, on January the 14th, students from around the state came to the University of Kentucky, the School of Engineering, there to participate in Future City Competition. Future City is a national competition where students have to design a city that's set hundreds of years into the future. Based on the research, they also have to write an essay which answers an in-depth engineering question. This year's question was based on how to design a city that would utilize primarily renewable energy. At UK, students had to present the scale model of their city and do a 7-minute presentation that included up to 8 minutes of questions from 4th and 5th year engineering students. Additionally, a group of 7th graders from Oldham Middle finished 3rd in the competition. By winning the competition, the 8th grade group will represent the state of Kentucky at the national finals in February 17th through 22nd, which I guess has already happened, in Washington, D.C. So we're going to recognize the eighth grade champions at this time. Ms. Sarah Sproul, is she here? Shannon Rush. And Connor Hounsell. We know you all will represent us very well in the state competition. From Oldham County High School, Oldham County High School's literary magazine, Spectrum, has received the rank of superior, nominated for highest award in the National Council of Teachers of English program to recognize excellence in student literary magazines. A total of 391 schools entered their magazines, 96 were nominated for highest award, and 38 received the highest award. So congratulations to Oldham County High School. Would Mr. Dees come down and receive a certificate from that or someone, please?
No, Mr. Dees.
You'll do.
You'll do.
From Oldham County Middle School, the Oldham County Middle School's PTSA received an award from the Kentucky PTA for 100% of the school's staff joining the PTSA for this school year. Congratulations. Mr. Kraft, would you come down, please? Tuesday, February 14th, we had a student at Oldham County High School collapse while he was in class. He went into cardiac arrest. Due to the quick response and heroic efforts of Assistant Principal Stan Drzewski and campus nurse Sherry Stone, this student's life was saved. At this meeting, we certainly want to recognize Stan and Sherry. Also, the events that occurred there has motivated us to put defibrillator devices in all the schools. There were several schools in our buildings that did not have those. We made sure that we've done that. We have 54 of our staff members, most all of our principals that were not certified, or all of them, will be participating in CPR training, getting certified. And so this event, as scary as it was, has certainly motivated all of us to get our act a little bit better in order, to make sure we're ready to save a life if we have to. So Stan and Sherry, would you please come in at this time?
This evening.
Great. Thank you, and welcome to North Oldham High School in the North Auditorium. If I could get the board members to come down and have a seat in the audience, that would be great, and then we'll get started. Phases in a student's school career, we believe, is the transition from one school to the next. Transition from elementary to middle, and certainly from middle to high school. At North Oldham High School, we've instituted a program that we call Mustang Mentors. And tonight you're going to hear from four of our outstanding seniors who have shown great leadership in this program. You're going to get to see a video. And let me also kind of give kudos to our leader within the building, Mr. Andrew Terry, who is one of our associate principals, and you will hear from him at the end of this presentation. So without further ado, Kyle, we're going to do the video first, and then you'll hear from these four students. Thank you.
Do you remember questions you had about high school, how nervous you were? I do. And I and the other students talking tonight can give the unique perspective of talking from the mentor's point of view, but also from the eighth grader's point of view, as we were the first to go through the program from both ends. In my personal experience with the mentor program. I go over there every first Wednesday of the month planning to help the eighth graders avoid the mistakes that I learned sort of the hard way going through high school. Granted, being the eighth grader of the first mentor program, I did learn a lot going through high school, going through the program before I got to high school, but going through the experience firsthand is a lot different than hearing about it talked or hearing it talked about. So I try to do my best to help the students avoid mistakes such as not reading the chapter in Mr. Grimm's AP Government class. That is not a good idea. And one of the perfect examples of how I learned, I remember in the mentor program, I was talking to one of the mentors about AP Psychology. My brother was in the course at the time, so I would hear about the class at dinner every night. So I talked to him about it, and he said the number one thing is keep up with the reading. And now that I'm taking that as a senior, I make sure that I keep up with the reading, and it definitely proves to work on all the tests. Thank you.
I'm Jordan Major. I'm a senior at North Oldham, and I was actually one of the first groups to go through my same mentors like Flynn, and I've never been through something harder as a senior than to get a group of eighth graders under control. It's very hard. I don't know if you guys have ever experienced it, but the leadership it takes to actually calm the kids down and talk to them about what they want to do in their future is very difficult. But the way Mustang Mentors is set up is so beneficial to us, and not only to the students, because it allows the mentors to really get to know and, you know, communicate with the students and practice our leadership abilities for next year in college, where maybe our audience won't be eighth graders. It will be professors and hopeful job interviews that we look to accomplish in the future. And Mustang Mentors has really helped me, and I'm sure it's other mentors, succeed in practicing leadership and just really taking on that role as being a mentor and being someone, a role model, who they want to look up to. And that's just really what I got from it. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Molly, and I'm a junior at North Oldham, and so this is my first year being part of the mentor program. I went through it as an eighth grader, and I just remember being an eighth grader, and it was so intimidating to talk to, you know, your teachers and your counselors and even administrators. So I think that the mentor program for eighth graders is something that's really unique because it gives them a chance to speak to people who they can relate to, who've recently been through the high school process. It's hard to be an eighth grader because you go from being the top dogs at your school, and so going to high school is a really interesting transition. It's completely new, different class schedules, different hours, different people. You get really mixed up. So I think that as an eighth grader, it's something that you really worry about. And as a mentor, it's exciting now to go in there and be like, it's not as scary as you think it is. They're just bigger people. And so I think that they really are able to relate to us and, you know, can take in what we say. So I know I remember my mentors from eighth grade, and I'll see them sometimes around town and wave to them. And, you know, like Flynn said, we've learned from their mistakes, and I've certainly listened to them when they're like, yeah, you got to keep up with this certain teacher and use this study guide in this class. So I think it's really unique for eighth graders because they're not as comfortable to talk to teachers, and so it's really cool to get to talk to them and know that they look up to us.
My name is Kyle Kozak, and I'm a senior here at North Oldham High School. And personally, I find that the mentor program is next in the way to give back to our community as a school program between the middle and high school. I see the kids all around now, all the time now, and they say, oh, hey, you're that guy that teaches me. You're that tall guy. They don't all know my name, but some of the better listeners do. But it's a great opportunity to help guide them through that transitionary phase between middle and high school. I remember one of the most difficult things for me was I didn't know much about high school, and it kind of terrified me. It was this big mountain of a thing we had to overcome. And I felt like the mentor program really helped, made it a much less scary threat to me. Personally, it's great being able to be part of that program and give back to these little kids. And it's great, and I think it's a great little system we've got going. Mr. Terry's done an excellent job with it.
He didn't realize he was so tall that he had to raise them. They put the short guy now. I just wanted to close this with just appreciation. Thank you for giving us the opportunity to kind of showcase a program that I think we at North Oldham are really proud of, and it's really driven by the kids. They do such a fantastic job over there with the eighth graders, and I talk to them all the time about it. They don't really realize it, but and actually they do, because they remember their mentors, and the mentors, the eighth graders, will remember them. And I was telling Ms. Jarrett a story earlier. I had a mentor in high school, and I can remember the kid's name. I know where Kevin Sullivan. He went to Miami University. You know, he wanted to be a pilot. This is 20 years ago, you know, that I'm talking about this kid. So I think these guys will make an impact on the kids that they're meeting with. The really cool thing about the mentor program is that it's not just about the eighth graders coming in and transitioning them to high school, but as you heard, it's about transitioning these guys into their next stage of life, which is a really cool thing. So I want to thank you again for the opportunity to come up and showcase the program, and I was going to say enjoy the rest of the show. I guess it's a show. Enjoy the rest of the meeting.
I would just like to say to Mr. Terry and Ms. Jarrett that we agree. This is a fabulous part of the culture at North Oldham High School. And you basically summarized what I had intended to say, Andrew, and that is not only are the eighth graders gaining from the high school students, but they in turn are gaining some very valuable leadership skills, which is, of course, one of our really high-valued characteristics for students graduating from Oldham County Schools. So thank you very much for all that you invest in your students here. I think we have one more presentation, Superintendent, and I'm going to invite past board member Mrs. Jones to the podium. Or a former board member, or something has happened to her.
Surprisingly. Surprise, I'm disrupting the meeting. This is Dave Price, and he's actually going to tell you a little bit more about what happened at Oldham County High School. And we've made a recognition at Oldham County Fiscal Court to the teachers and staff from Oldham County High. And this is more indicative of what really happened that day. And we thought it was important that the board really, and the audience.
I'm going to ask you to raise the mic. Can you
hear me? Yeah. Here we go. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm here today because of the heroic actions of the individuals of Oldham County High School now 2 weeks ago. When a person's heart stops beating, the first minutes are critical. Brain injury is likely if cardiac arrest occurs and goes untreated for more than 5 minutes. The treatment of cardiac arrest is cardiopulmonary resuscitation. To provide circulatory support followed by defibrillation if a shockable rhythm is advised. If a shockable rhythm is not present after CPR, clinical death is inevitable. Studies have shown that an out-of-hospital cardiac arrest only has a 5% chance of walking out of the hospital. Because of the swift actions of our educational staff last week, we have a student who has become one of those lucky few. A student became unconscious during the day Tuesday. Their teacher quickly recognized the problem and notified the office that something had happened within her classroom. CPR was then started. Soon after the arrival of additional staff as well as the school's AED, the AED was placed on the student and the shockable rhythm was found. The AED delivered the shock and CPR was continued. After 2 minutes, the AED advised that there was still a shockable rhythm. Again, it delivered that shock. CPR was continued, at which time Oldham County EMS arrived and the ambulance crew put the student on the cardiac monitor, and again, a shockable rhythm was still there. The school nurse, Sherry Stone, continued CPR while the ambulance crew prepared their equipment. After the appropriate time, a forced shock was then delivered. at which time we found a pulse before we left the classroom. High-quality care was continued throughout our time with the patient, but it is, in my opinion, as both the paramedic as well as the American Heart Association Training Center coordinator, that without the swift actions of the educational staff, that student wouldn't be with us today. A young life was saved because of the parties and because of the training and collaborative effort from all parties involved. Again, we've got some other little things we're actually going to give to the teachers and staff when we see them again. I'm actually probably going to go deliver those tomorrow. But I can't speak enough to what they did that day. I've been talking with Melanie Dowdy about getting a for sure number of CPR instructors that we have within the school system. And I know at that point in time, the school nurse had actually done mouth-to-mouth, and we hope not to put people in that position again, because that's just really not what we want to do to be safe. So we as Oldham County EMS are actually going to donate a CPR mask for every instructor that we have within the school system, so that hopefully that doesn't happen again. There was one there, but I think just within the moment, things were going kind of crazy. Obviously, I mean, that's one of the most chaotic times you're ever going to find yourself in. So I'm hoping we can decrease that chance just a little bit by giving the school system the CPR mask. Any questions?
No, but thank you for the further summary and the recognition of the heroics of our staff members. We can't say enough about how pleased we are with the outcome of that situation.
Yeah, it's my understanding that student's going to be back at school, I believe, sometime this week.
Yes. Yes. Okay. All right. Thank you so much for being here, you all.
Thank you, Ms. Jones, for your continued support.
We are ready at this time in the evening for our monthly public expression. Mr. Williams? All right. Nobody has signed in to address the board, so we'll move ahead quickly. Action item E, Superintendent.
This is to ask the board to approve the school calendar for the 2012-13 school year. Mr. Williams heads up the calendar committee.
Good evening.
Good evening. Before you see the calendar that the committee has proposed with the modification that Mr. Dotson had asked for at our last meeting when you had your first preview of the calendar. I would be more than happy to answer any questions, but really at this point it is just asking for your approval of the calendar.
Right. And I applaud Mr. Dotson for the suggested changes that he requested for the school calendar. I think they were both good decisions, and thank you, Mr. Williams, for implementing those changes.
You're welcome.
Other questions or comments? Superintendent?
I recommend for approval.
All right. Motion to approve, please. Made by Mr. Dotson and seconded by Mr. Woosley. All those in favor, and that's 5-0. Thank you, Mr. Williams, for your leadership on the school calendar committee.
Thank you, ma'am.
Let's go ahead, Superintendent, with action item F, please. So
these are four policies that you saw last month that Ms. Corson has prepared. And if you have questions, we'll sure answer them for you.
Right. We have seen these policies before, board members, so we've had a month to consider our questions and concerns. Any additional comments? All right, may I have a motion to approve action item F, please? Motion made by Mr. Shum, seconded by Mr. Dotson. All those in favor, and that's 5-0. Thank you, Superintendent. That was your recommendation, wasn't it, sir? Okay, moving right along. Action item G, sir.
This is the 2012-13 tentative SBDM allocations for the schools. Mr. Davis has that. Very extensive report, as you see every year.
Yes, it is.
Basically, what we have here is the projection of the tentative schedule of site-based allocations for fiscal year 2012-13. Basically, what you can see here is this is required to be submitted to the schools by March 1st, and then the final, once we get total legislative update on SEEK and good projected enrollment number. These will be finalized, and that is required to be sent into KDE by May the 1st. Basically, what we have here are the allocations that are based on current information in terms of the school enrollment. The SEEK has been based at 3833 per student, which is down from 3903 from the previous year. and therefore that affects the 3.5% that's for teacher or the materials, student materials. So basically what we have here is I'd just like for you to approve this tentative allocation so we can forward it on to the schools, and then the final allocations due May 1st will be subject to the various changes and estimates, and we'll have some fairly good numbers from the state by that time.
Right. Thank you, Mr. Davis. Questions or comments?
While Mr. Woosley is getting his microphone together, I would like to compliment the staff, the treasurer's administrative department, and the superintendent in a very difficult year where we held the line on tax increases. You've continued to show through 22-to-1 staffing in the classroom that we can actually achieve excellence in your job. And I want to thank you because I know you work very diligently to get these allocations together and to still provide the schools with the necessary staffing and equipment that they would need. Thank you, sir.
Mr. Woosley, did you have a question, sir?
I was going to say that because I had a question. Professional development at the school level was cut. Was that money used at the district level then? Professional development.
What item are you referring to, Mr. Woosley?
Section 9, professional development. Mm-hmm. Was that, looks like it was lower than what it was last
year. I think the projection is that it'd be lower for the 12-13 school year.
Yeah, the state hasn't approved it yet.
We don't have our funding numbers yet from the state of Kentucky.
It's just based on.
Right. So there will be several figures in here that will either be the same or will be reflected as zeros because we don't have it.
This is just a tentative allocation based on what we have knowledge to date, but it will be subject to change when we finalize it May 1st.
Yes.
That lowering of per pupil there really affects everything. It affects the amounts to the councils, which is what this report's about, but it also affects some of the other categorical programs. That's going to make next year's budget even more challenging.
Yes. Other questions or comments, board members? Your recommendation, Superintendent?
To approve, please.
May I have a motion to approve this action item, please? Motion made by Mr. Woosley and seconded by Ms. Beckner. All those in favor, and that's 5-0. Thank you, Mr. Davis, and your department. Board members, just a reminder that we have two information items for review at the end of our agenda. The first is an update from the Head Start program, and the second is the monthly district energy usage report. So please take those under advisement. Your recommendation now, Superintendent?
We adjourn, please.
Motion to adjourn, please, made by Mr. Dodson, seconded by Ms. Beckner. All those in favor, and that's 5-0. Safe trip home, everybody.